Good evening, everybody. All the waving getting out of the way already. Everybody give a big wave over here. Say hi to mom and dad. There we go. Welcome to the Bearspaw Christian School Christmas Concert. We missed you over the last couple of years, and tonight we're just so thankful to be together with all of you. My name is Dave Anger, and I'm the head of school at BCS, and this is Jen Lockhart, who's the elementary principal. We are really happy to be back here after this COVID time. What a blessing it is. We hope that tonight gets you into the Christmas spirit as we get ready to celebrate the birth of our Savior. I want you to know that at BCS, we won't be saying season's greetings. We won't be wishing you happy holidays, but we are here to wish you a Merry Christmas. Today in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is Messiah. He is Christ the Lord. We believe in our school. We believe in the message that we're able to proclaim at our school. We believe that BCS is needed. Schools like ours are needed more in our world, in our province, and in our city, and for our families, even more now than they've ever been needed before. You know, while I have the mic, we are planning to grow BCS, and I just want to remind you, if you haven't heard about our next chapter about growing Bearspaw Christian School, there's a link in your program. We'd love to see you make a donation. We invite you to do that. We have a gala coming up on February 4th with special guest Country Music Hall of Fame singer Paul Brandt will be performing at our gala. So we're so excited to work with Paul. But I know you're not here to listen to me. So I'm going to take the mic. I'm going to give it to Jen. Thank you all for being here. Merry Christmas.
They're not here to listen to me either. They want to get on with the show. It's such an honor to work at Bearspaw Christian School. I feel so grateful. I love getting to know each and every one of your children. They are such a blessing to me each and every day. They're smiling faces that come in the door, and yes, it's been 3 years since we've had a Christmas concert, and we are more full than we expected to be, so I am sorry for those guests at the back that are having to stand that we don't quite have enough seating for, but what an amazing evening this is going to be. Just a reminder that we have a few things that I need to remind you of. We do need children that are younger to be sitting with their families and not blocking the aisles, and keeping this area up here clear. I know many of you will want to get pictures, which is fine, but if you can leave the front area clear for our directors, that would be very helpful. We do have Michael Nemec around taking pictures throughout the evening, and we will put those into a drive and share that out with you. So you will have some of those pictures, and you are welcome to take pictures after the show of your children as well. What else? Grade one parents, your kids are going to do a couple songs. Once they are finished, they're going to file off the stage. They're going to go to the foyer with their teacher at the back. They'll be lined up. We'll do it dismissal style, right? So like we do at the end of every school day, we'd like you to be orderly, sending one parent out to get them. And as that is happening, we're going to have the grade 2 to 4s file up. And then we're just going to start the show right after that with our Christmas County Spelling Bee. So we hope you have a wonderful evening. Thank you so much for coming. And we are going to pray. I'll hand that over to Mr. Anger.
Heavenly Father, thank you for our school. Thank you for these families, and thank you for these kids. God, we're here because we love you. We want you to be honored as we prepare our hearts for Christmas and the coming of a Savior. Would you be glorified? Would you receive praise in everything that is said and done here tonight? We honor you and we love you. Amen.
What an exciting time of year, Christmas! And we are here to celebrate the true reason for the season, Jesus. That's why we have decided to have a traditional live annual manger pageant at Town Hall. So many of you people want to participate. We have decided to choose our cast through this spelling bee competition. You see, nobody loses in this bee. Everyone participating will get a part in the pageant, honoring our Lord today.
As a reminder, our contestants will be spelling the many names and titles of Jesus.
That's right, there are over 700 names for Jesus in the Bible,
and each one reveals to us more of his character and how he works in our lives.
What a marvelous Christmas gift we received from the Father 2,000 years ago.
Listen up as I explain how the bee will work. When your number is called, please step up to the microphone. Then you will be given a name to spell.
You may ask for a definition, a sentence, a song, or language of origin. If you hear this, what do you think it means?
An angel gets its wings.
Wrong Christmas show. No, if you hear the spell, it means that you have spelled incorrectly. Please step down as you are told what part you will be playing in the pageant. Proceed over to our wardrobe lady, Miss Finch.
Remember, the winner will be featured as either Mary or Joseph.
Without any further ado, let's begin this year's annual Christmas County Spelling Bee.
Contestant number one, Joy Finley. Please step up to the microphone.
This is Joy's second year in the Bee. Her brother Ethan made it to the final round last year.
Ready?
R-E-A-D-Y.
No.
N-O.
Stop.
S-T-O-P.
Those are not your words. Your word is Lord.
Oh. Lord. L-O-R-D. Lord?
Correct. Number two, Katie Collins.
Katie Collins is this year's cheerleading captain, and I'm sure she has some friends cheering for her today.
Go, Katie!
Your word is word.
Sentence, please.
Your word is word.
You just said that. Sentence, please.
That was the sentence. Word is the word. Word is the word.
Oh, that word. Word. W-O-R-D. Word.
Correct. Contestant number three, Jeffrey Johnson. Please step up to the mic.
Jeffrey Johnson is quite an athlete. He's on the hockey, football, and baseball teams.
Spell light.
Sentence, please.
Jesus said, I'm the light of the world.
Song, please.
All right, but no peeking.
L-I-G-H-T, light.
Correct.
Contestant number four, Ferris Wheeler.
It's Wyler.
Okay, Mr. Wyler, would you please step up and spell El Shaddai?
Are you kidding?
Gotcha, Wheeler.
It's Wyler!
Just kidding, your word is savior.
Savior, S-A-V-I-O-U-R. Savior?
Correct. Thank you for using the correct Canadian spelling.
Number five, Beatrice B. Beasley. Please step up to the microphone and spell Morning Star.
Notice Miss Beasley's bumblebee-inspired outfit.
As I recall, she wore something similar last year.
Morning Star. M-O-R-N-I-N-G-S-T-A-R. Morning Star?
Correct.
I know that.
Contestant number six, Randy Richard. Please step up and spell Yahweh.
What? Is that in the word?
Yes, it is, and the language of origin is Hebrew.
Of course. Could I have a definition, please?
Yahweh is the Old Testament name for the Lord God.
Can I just spell God?
You mean, may I just spell God?
May I just spell God?
No, we choose the words, Randy. This name was considered to be so sacred that for centuries it was not spoken aloud.
If they're not supposed to say it, are you sure I should be spelling it?
Your word is Yahweh.
Yahweh. Y-A-H-W-A-Y. Yahweh.
You lose, but you still win.
That's right, folks. It's begun. We have our first small part awarded for the major scene.
Randy will play a wise man.
Please see Miss Finch for your wise man costume.
Contestant number seven, Grace Okoro, please approach the mic and spell Redeemer.
Dear Jesus, I sure could use a Redeemer right now. Please help me spell this correctly. R-E-D-E-E-M-E-R. Redeemer?
Correct.
Yes, thank you to Jesus, my true Redeemer.
Contestant number eight, Bella McDowell, please spell Lamb.
Song, please.
Number eight, please see Miss Finch. You'll be a lamb tonight.
Wow, that was intense.
She really did take that well. Good thing she's as gentle as a lamb.
Contestant number nine, it's your turn to sparkle and shine. Ruby St. Clair, please spell shepherd.
Jesus was a shepherd? Sentence, please.
Jesus said, I'm the good shepherd. The good shepherd lays down his life for his sheep.
And that's just what Jesus did. We are his sheep.
And he is the good shepherd who gave his life for us.
Shepherd. S-H-E-P-H-E-R-D. Shepherd.
Correct. Contestant number 10, Ember Allen. Please step up to spell your word. Your name to spell is Wonderful Counselor.
I'm sure many of you will remember Ember from last year. She was so tense that she froze up at the microphone.
Oh no, not again. Breathe, Ember, breathe.
Again, number 10, Wonderful Counselor?
For those of you who have never actually seen a deer in your headlights, Ember is doing a pretty good impression of one right now.
Breathe, Ember, breathe. And now, Ember would probably ask for a sentence, right? Sentence, please.
And he will be called Wonderful Counselor.
Ember? And now I think Ember should be asking for a song.
Oh, good. This should give Ember a little time to calm down and get those nerves under control.
Let's take some time to praise the Lord for always leading us in wisdom and truth.
Wonderful counselor, teach me what's right.
wonderful counselor to calm her nerves.
Great job!
That officially ends round one of the spelling bee. Good work, everyone. Let's proceed on.
What a fantastic job all of our participants are doing spelling the beautiful names of our Lord.
Did you know that no other person in history has had as many names and titles? I think that's because his glory and greatness is beyond description.
We are back to number one, Joy Finley. Your word to spell is Elohim.
Hello? Hello? Hello, hello, hello? Elohim? May I please have the language of origin?
Elohim is the third word in the Hebrew Bible, and it's used over 2,600 times.
2,600 times? I'm not even sure if I can spell it once. E-L-O-H-E-E-M, Elohim?
I'm sorry, that's incorrect. Please see Miss Finch for your wise man costume.
Contestant number two, your word is fortress.
Fortress, F-O-R-T-R-E-S-S, fortress?
Correct. Number three, Jeffrey Johnson.
Ladies, please. Oh, I don't mind.
Please spell the name Mighty God.
The Lord your God is in your midst, a mighty one who will save.
Save.
Could you use it in a really cool song?
I'm the one that's got you.
Mighty God. M-I-G-H-T-Y-G-O-D. Mighty God?
Correct. You're safe for another round.
Move along, ladies.
Number 4, Ferris Wheeler.
It's Wyler!
Okay, number 4. Your name to spell is Everlasting Father.
Everlasting Father. E-V-E-R-L-A-S-T-I-N-G-F-A-T-H-E-R. Everlasting Father?
Correct.
Moving along. Number 5, Beatrice B. Beasley. Would you spell Prince of Peace?
Prince of Peace. Isn't that a good title for her? Beatrice Beasley is known for staying as busy as a bee all the time, especially at Christmas.
Prince of Peace. P-R-I-N-C-E-O-F-P-I-E-C-E. Prince of Peace?
Sorry, honeybee.
I guess it's bye-bye to Beasley.
Beasley, you'll be a star in the pageant.
A star? Me? I'd love to be a star. My first word was Morning Star. Thank you for letting me be in your nativity.
Contestant number 7, Grace Okoro. Please spell Adonai.
Adonai? I don't know. A-D-D-A-N-I? Adonai?
I'm sorry, that's incorrect. Adonai is spelled A-D-O-N-A-I. Please see Miss Finch for your shepherd costume.
Contestant number 9, it's your turn again. Please spell Omega.
Omega? Oh boy, may I have a verse, please?
Revelation 22:13. I'm the Alpha and the Omega, the first and the last, the beginning and the end.
Omega. O-H-M-E-G-A. Omega?
I'm sorry, this is the end of the B for you. There is no H in Omega. You get to be a shepherd.
Number 10, Amber Allen. Please spell Jehovah.
Oh no, here we go again.
May we have a sentence, please?
Perhaps Amber could use some encouragement. Do not fear appears several times in the Christmas story.
That's right. Let's encourage Amber with a song.
Thank you.
I will not be afraid, Jehovah. J-E-H-O-V-A-H, Jehovah.
Correct.
We are officially entering round three of the B. Will we have a Mary winner or a Joseph winner?
Number two, Katie Collins. Please spell the name Restorer.
Restorer? R-E-S-T-O-R-E. Restorer?
I'm sorry, there is one more R at the end of Restorer. Go get your angel costume on, Katie.
Miss Collins is out of the B word, down to three.
Number three, Jeffrey Johnson. Please spell the name mediator.
Can I have a definition, please?
Someone who intervenes in a dispute to find an agreement.
Kind of like a referee, right?
Yes, Jeffrey, it is like a referee.
Thank you. Referee. R-E-F-E-R-E-E. Referee?
I'm sorry, I thought it was more appropriate. Jeffrey, your word was mediator, not referee.
Oh, dude, no.
I'm sorry, you're out of the B.
Can I talk to a mediator, please?
The decision of the referee, I mean the judge, is final.
Thought I'd try, bye.
Go get your Wiseman costume on, Jeffrey.
Number four, Ferris Wheeler, not Wheeler. Please spell the name Deliverer.
Deliverer, D-E-L-I-V-E-R-E-R, Deliverer?
Correct.
Number 10, your name to spell is Messiah.
Now I know I do not need to be afraid. I will not mess this up. Messiah, M-E-S-S-I-A-H, Messiah.
Correct.
We are down to two. Will we have a Mary winner or a Joseph winner?
Let's see as we enter the final round.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have a tie. According to the rules of the Christmas County Spelling Bee, when there are two contestants left, they are both to spell the same word by writing it down. Please take your whiteboards and move to separate sides of the stage.
Contestants, please write down the correct spelling of Nazarene.
So it was fulfilled what was said through the prophets, he will be called a Nazarene. Matthew 2, verse 23.
May I see your answers, please?
Nazarene.
You are both correct.
Good. Take your whiteboards and spell your final word.
Please spell the name Emmanuel.
Tension is high in town hall. Let's give them some additional time to think.
Let's sing to Emmanuel, which means God with us.
God with us, Emmanuel, Emmanuel.
May I see your answers, please?
It looks like we've got a winner. Ember spelled it correctly. I-M-N-A-N-U-E-L.
No, Fair spelled correctly. E-M-M-A-N-U-E-L.
Order! Order in the town hall! I said order!
I believe we have a Mary and a Joseph. They're both correct. Congratulations.
Congratulations, Ember and Ferris. Great job. Make your way quickly to Miss Finch and get your costumes on. The Christmas pageant has been kept, and we are just moments away. Can I have stage crew bring on our manger set, please?
If I may, I would just like to add a personal thank you to all our contestants. Like many of you here today, I've learned so much about the Lord Jesus as we've looked at his many names.
That's correct. He's truly our wonderful counselor and our mighty God, and incredibly much more, Emmanuel. Our God has been with us ever since he entered our world, that wonderful holy night in the manger bed. Let's worship and praise our Savior today, Jesus, the name above all names.
Bethlehem, the town of David. He went there to register with Mary, who pledged to be married to him and was expecting a child.
While they were there, the time came for the baby to be born, and she gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in cloths and placed him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn.
Shepherds living out in the field nearby, keeping watch over their flocks at night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news that will cause great joy to all the people. Today in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord."
After Jesus was born, Magi from the east came to Jerusalem and asked, "Where is the one who has been born, King of the Jews? We saw his star from the east and have come to worship him."
They bowed down and worshipped him.
Christmas, if you've asked Jesus to be your Lord and Savior, the Bible says he's written your name on the palm of his mighty hand.
Hey kids, how do you spell love?
J-E-S-U-S.
For unto us a child is born,
unto us a son is given,
and the government will be upon his shoulders.
And his name will be called...
Wasn't that incredible? Please give them another round of applause.
Well done, you guys. You can have a seat. Guys, have a seat.
Oh, what a blessing it is to have your children on this stage sharing the message of Jesus this Christmas. I've truly missed seeing this over the last few years and us being able to celebrate and just glorify our Lord Jesus. Isaiah 9:6 reads, "For to us a son is born, to us a son is given, and the government will be on his shoulders, and he will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace." What a special gift it is to be able to be reminded of the character of God through the many names we call our Savior. The one who was born over 2,000 years ago, a wonderful gift sent to us as a babe in a manger. At BCS, we get the opportunity to learn about each of these names of God each month through our chapel in Bible memory verses, and the opportunity that we get to impact your children for eternity is just such an amazing gift. Helping them to learn and grow in their Christian faith is an amazing opportunity that we do not take for granted. We are so grateful that we get to partner with each of you as families in raising up these children. Give them another round of applause. So next to me is a new face to BCS. This lady is Karen Braun. She is my lead teacher as well as resource director, and she has been one of the ladies at the back that has been doing our sound tonight. I'm so grateful to have her join our team, and we have a few thank yous that we'd like to do, and then I'll have Karen close in prayer. So if we can please have Mrs. Wilson, Mrs. Moore, and Mrs. Brooks to the stage, please. Guys, just don't give it yet, okay? So as you can imagine, putting on a concert like this is no small feat. It takes months of practicing, and these ladies have dedicated their time to working with the children during music class to learn the songs, as well as after schools and Friday afternoons to work with the cast that did all of the acting, the light show, the cheerleaders, and it was phenomenal. So we have Mrs. Brooks. Guys, who has Mrs. Brooks? We'd like to present you with a small token of gratitude. Mrs. Moore. And Mrs. Wilson. Thank you so much, ladies. We appreciate each and every one of you. All right, we are going to close in prayer, and then what will happen is your children will exit off the stage and into the rooms that you drop them off in. It gets very crowded, so we'll have to be patient as we have one parent go and get them from the rooms. Please drive safe as you leave this evening as well.
It was indeed an incredible evening, and what a blessing for me to be in this place at this time tonight. Thank you so much for being part of it. Please bow your head as we close in prayer. Heavenly Father, thank you for this wonderful night tonight, full of fun, laughter, beautiful singing, and great performances. Loving Father, as we go out tonight, help us remember the birth of Jesus, not just as a sweet part of our Christmas story, but as the beginning of your journey on earth, leading to your sacrifice of dying on the cross to save us from our sins. Tonight we learned about some of your names. Let us remember not just the little baby lying in the manger, but also how you are, Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Prince of Peace, Emmanuel, Everlasting Father, Jesus, name above all names. Guide us as we leave here tonight. Show us how we can share your love with others. Be with those for whom Christmas will bring pain this year, for those that are lonely and for those that are sick. Be with those less fortunate than us and guide us to reach out in your name. Holy Spirit, we ask that you come among us and travel with us as we leave here. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Thank you for coming.